what makes someone interesting.
Now let's get it all in perspective for all y'all enjoyment, a song y'all can step with.
What they do, what they've done, where they've been, where they're from. Milton checks them all. Born different in a foreign land, coming to New York with just an idea. His story is unlike any I've ever heard, and I've heard a lot. So let's begin with a question I've never asked a single person in my life.
Your mother was a Korean prostitute.
She was. I'm from South Korea. It's a town called Bukbyeong, which is considered a camp town, and a camp town is a Korean town that revolves around a U.S. military base. Because that's the economy, that's the protection.
So basically, at that time in Korea, prostitution was sanctioned by the military with the intent of keeping the soldiers happy. It was also the only way for Korean villages to sustain any kind of economic standard, since there weren't too many choices for work back then.
She was a prostitute, but she was also a great mother. I think she fulfilled her obligation of every child needs to know that they're loved by the parent. I don't know my father. You know, never did. I do know that I caught hell every day for being black. And that's even before I even knew what black was. And you know, it hurt like hell, but it was confusing to me because I was the only kid out there built like a superhero. Why is my world rejecting me the way that I am because I was different? And I didn't even know what this difference was.
You know, at the time, being different and kind of feeling isolated was such a terrible, awful feeling. But now, do you see it as kind of a superpower?
This feeling that can be so damaging for somebody else, you know, I kind of relish. And, you know, so as I'm looking at the kids, I'm like, out of all of us, I'm the one that's going to get to America. I'm going to become big and strong and powerful. I'm going to use my power for good.
And that's exactly what he did. His mother was eventually wrongly incarcerated, which left Milton at an orphanage.
She gave me a really big, long hug, and I remember she whispered in my ear, she told me to be strong. And that was the last day that I saw her. I think it was her way of telling me that she loved me. She had shown that to me all throughout my life.
Milton was then adopted by the Washington family, who brought him to the States, where he played football.
Football scholarship, played at Northwestern, got hurt early in my career in 2002, made the decision to move to New York.
And that's when his big ideas came, in the form of fitness with ROKMIL, a cannabis company of the same name. And of course, his photography, using only an iPhone.
This is it, what? Luchini pouring from the sky, let's get rich, what? The Jiki Fonsa Sugar Dimes, can't quit, what?
I had always thought that I was a better photographer than many of the photographs that I had seen. And it was the iPhone 3 that allowed me to go, you know, let me start taking some photos.
So you walk around, see this woman right here, and you say, come on over, stand right there, picture time.
I've done it. And actually, I don't think I do enough of it.
Yeah. You style them, or do they come with these clothes on? And then the backgrounds, how do you choose the backgrounds?
So the styling part is a collaboration.
Well, a lot of your photographs, which is amazing, is it's a subject, but you're also mesmerized by the background.
To me, the background is the math that really helps feature and complement the subject. Mm-hmm. Anytime I'm in an Uber, I'm just driving by taking shots. Saw this parking garage on the Upper East Side.
That's a parking garage.
That's it.
That's not the one I parked at today.
Probably not.
I'll tell you that right now. You find that Harlem is a part of all of your art?
Absolutely. As a kid in South Korea, when I'm talking about getting to America, I didn't know it, but I was talking about Harlem. Almost a bombastic nature. We're loud with it. Mm-hmm. You know? Harlem is loud with it. And if you love it, this is like, I feel like I'm really living.
Each one of these photographs, you can see majesty. That's one thing you see.
So Sharon Bullock, 70 years old, looking like a superhero.
Yeah.
I'm like, hey, can we take a little shot?
Yes.
Boom, boom, boom. Such flavor.
Yeah.
And you get that right outside of your door.
You don't get that everywhere.
You don't. I got a stoop on the ad, a little black boy from South Korea.
Yeah, man.
Who wanted to come home to blackness. Like, come on, tell me I'm not living.
Because you think about all the pain that you suffered in South Korea with being made fun of, and then you're here, and it has to feel so comfortable.
It does. It does.
Can you find somebody here on the street spontaneously? And we want to see you in action. We want to see your magic.
Yeah.
You do it?
Yeah.
But first, we needed an aesthetically pleasing doorway. which we soon found.
And let me tell you why. To me, it's a good one.
Because it says 100 over it.
Well, there's that. So anyone that's wearing something else outside of black, this can work.
And with that, we found a guy who's wearing the most not black outfit we've seen all day.
I'm a photographer. We just gonna take a photo.
Oh, okay.
Boom. Yeah. Do whatever you feel.
Do whatever you feel.
Oh, okay, I'll put my happy face, because you know what? I wake up with no stress. Too black to be stressed.
People here and wanna, and they wanna know how and why, but let me first introduce myself. I'm tagged the name of mine. I'm 22 years of age. I ran across the bush. Hey, people, promise you.
You're the best, Super Dave. Thank you very
much,
man.
Appreciate you, man.
But it wasn't just about the photos. Milton and I had to discuss his fitness company, ROKMIL.
So ROKMIL Fitness is what I call indigenous fitness. But it's this full body system of movements that gives you what I call the golden trifecta of fitness. True strengthening, true cardio, true flexibility, and a whole bunch of other stuff that the average person would want. But that whole system of movements is around an African stool called a Balamaki stool.
So it's not a lot of weights, really?
With support, no. It's body weights.
Body weights.
It's all body weights.
How old are you?
53.
God bless. I'll have what he's having. Do you smoke before you work out?
Every session.
You do?
Every session.
Do you high right now?
Yes.
Great.
I'm the alpha with no omega, beginning without the...
And this is called the Buddha.
And I think, like, another key to life is just relaxing.
I'm gonna rip my skinny jeans.
Rhymes everlasting, there'll be no part two. Knowledge is infinite. Once I start to draw a better picture for your third eye. If you're blind, you know what a mic. I'm a black microwave.
So I ask again, what makes someone interesting? I think Milton has answered that question. Where he's been, what tried to hold him down, and what was there to help push him past it all. Some people are just born with it. No matter what their tumultuous origin or circumstances, they find their way, their voice, themselves. For Milton, it took Harlem to get there, and he never forgets it. Because in the end, he's just a kid from South Korea who dreamed of America and ended up in the middle of all of it. His photos, a love letter to the place he now calls home.
I'll take you there.
Shots for larger blocks of cash.